selection that you just made. Sister Lila, she's coming to see our soul this morning. After that, you'll be in the hands of the speaker for the hour. Another house in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Pray for me. I've tempted the sin that's all the time that it's not going to be so. There's a story behind my praise. That's why my hands, I'll continue to raise. I'm gonna praise Him for the rest of my days. I might not open my mouth, but I'll lift my
some of us, he was, from alcohol. Alcohol almost killed some of us, but he brought us. How long? It was a mighty long way. Hallelujah. Some of us was had cancer. Some had liver disease. Was at death door. Not just knocking once, but twice. The door was about to open. Hallelujah. But I got a story to tell. Hallelujah. It was a mighty long way. Hallelujah. I remember, praise God, I had to say as early as I get. Because this is another part I didn't tell everybody. Praise God. When I had my condition, amen, it was early. And some people thought it was a joke. But I was asking for just a piece of liver. I said, can you just give me a piece? Praise God. I asked the guys on my job, because I didn't know any different at this time. Amen. It was early, they just had found out about it. So I was trying to find out who was my blood type and who could make a donation for me. Praise God. And I was just asking for a piece of liver. They thought it was funny. They were first working in single, but when they thought, say, I want a piece of liver, they just got a partner. Everybody started working together because they thought I was crazy. Hallelujah. It was a little humorous because, you know, spirit, you coming around the corner, they think you're after that liver. I praise God. Amen. My brother, he got it. I wanted to get his liver, same blood type. And he said, okay, I'll call you back and let you know. I waited 2 weeks, and when I did finally hear from him, he said he couldn't do it. Okay. Praise God. And then my nephew said he would help me. And when it got closer to time, he said, I don't know if I can do it. We went to the hospital there in the Bronx. Amen. Getting there on 168th Street. Praise God. My brother-in-law went with me that day, and I was so weak and frail looking. Amen. It looked like I was a dead person walking. And praise God. And you know, when you like that, you're delusional, and you're not in your right thoughts, and you're very emotional. Don't take nothing to make you cry. There I was. And he said he couldn't do it either. So what happened? God, he let me take the rope that I tried, and he took over. They didn't help me, but God said, I'm still here. He said, I'm still here. Amen. At the end, at the crossroad, I was getting ready to cross over. When somebody died for me. Another human being gave their life for me. I have their liver. And I praise God for that person died in the car accident. Mercy upon his soul, but he died in a car accident so that I could live continually on this earth. And when I said it in prayer that morning, that was about a couple weeks ago, and I said, Lord, I thank you for allowing me to stay here a little longer by giving me somebody else's liver, but I thank you for eternal life. Not because I can live beyond this world, because of what Jesus did on the cross. He died for my sins. So now, amen, he made the greatest sacrifice that could ever be made. Praise God. Hallelujah! He died for me. I didn't have to beg. He was just willing to give himself. And he gave all he had. He poured out his soul, amen, unto death. And because he lived, I can live also. Lift our hand and give God praise. Come on, give him praise. Hallelujah! Because he lives, I can live. Thank God for that young boy that gave his life 30 years old. But thank God for Jesus, most of all. Because to have life in this world continually and without Christ, you might as well be dead. Because we need Christ to have eternal life. We're going to die one day, and you should make sure that your life is in his hands. Don't play with God. It's time. I like what the man said in the big advertisement. He said, time is like 1 hour, studded with 60 golden minutes. And there's no reward for it once it's lost. There's no reward, so ain't no sense in trying to find it, because once opportunity goes, it's like that clock ticking. And when it hit the number, you out of here. And you get over there, other place, and say, what can I do to get this right? Like the rich man, when he died, he lifted up his eyes in hell, and he cried out to Abraham that was on the other side. He said, Father Abraham, can you send Lazarus over here to help me? Now, they call him Diabetes. Said, well, I would like to help you, but there's a big gulf here. We can't cross one from here, and can nobody come from there to here. I would like to help you, but it's too late. Yeah. Time to move on. He kept obeying. He kept obeying. And there, amen, he said, send somebody else there. If you ain't gonna let me go back, send somebody else there to tell my brothers, because I don't want them coming down here. You know, the man was so selfish that he, even in his death, he was thinking about himself. But then he knew that he was gonna get a good beating when they got there. Praise God, because he had to see them. Saints, when time moves on, you that are unsaved in the house of God today, remember, take it seriously, that when time moves on, you can't throw a hook in the water and pull it back. You can't get the soothsayer or witch to try to, amen, pull up, or what they call it, try to pull Samuel up from the grave, because Saul has so many problems. Ain't no witch can help you. If you don't follow God's word, you are going to hell. You got to come now. Today is the day of salvation. Not tomorrow. Today is all we got. And if we let this day slip away, tomorrow God will have his say. Today is all we got is today. Hallelujah. Today is the acceptable time. Today is the day of salvation. Do you know Jesus today? If you don't know him, this is the time to find him. This is the time to come to him and put your arms around him as he embraces you. He wants to embrace somebody today. I said he wants to embrace somebody. He got a lot of love for somebody that's hurting. He got a lot of love for somebody that's feeling rejected. They're feeling cast down. Turn upside down and turn aside. God knows how to help us when we're in our crisis. But what you're going to do, don't keep repeating the same thing over and over again. Come on, it's time, pray God, to fix it once and for all. I said it's time to fix it once and for all. Praise God. Get a new doctor. That doctor you've been going to, he's been lying to you. He's been fixing you, giving you stuff you really need. But Jesus got the right antidote. He got the right medicine for your ill. He knows how to fix it. He knows how to heal. Praise God. Hallelujah. I want to do what God said. We're done in our pastor today. We thank God for him coming back off the trip. Him and his wife. Amen. Thank God for him in Jesus' name. Amen. I tell you, today, I'm going to let pride take a seat. I'm going to trust God today. Hallelujah. That's my Savior. God wants somebody to miss hell and enter into glory. Come on. The devil wants your soul. But you don't have to give it to him because it's yours. You can make a choice who can have your soul. Today you can compromise, amen, with the devil, make some deals with him, but you ought to tell him, no deal, devil. I ain't giving up this soul. This is mine. Took a lot to get this soul. Hallelujah. They had to think about me for 9 months. And I came here. And my soul belongs to God. You acceptable time. Hallelujah. Awake, awake! You that are asleep. It's time, praise God, to take note of the hour because it's growing late. Your days are numbered. What are you going to do with time? What are you going to do with time? Make good use of it. While you got your right mind, while the blood is still warm, running warm in your veins, you need to make a sober choice. Because if you don't move today, there's not promise what will happen tomorrow. God only gives you today. Tomorrow, He will work. Judgment comes tomorrow. What does that mean? Does that mean that you live it today, but tomorrow you might not see tomorrow? Our life is like a vapor. Amen. Whew. You see it on the glass, then after a while it just fades away. What will you do with this Jesus? What will you do with him? Will you just use him for a little good times and use him when you just need him most? What will you do with this Jesus? He's the sacrifice that God gave as a propitiation for our sins. He is the sacrifice. He's the Lamb of God that God has gave to take away the sins of those who would repent of their sins and turn their lives over to Jesus Christ. There's no other hope outside of Christ. That's why God sent him. There was nobody else good enough to come because everybody else was defiled and diseased with sin from Adam. But thank God for the victory through Jesus Christ. Thank you for the holiness of a righteous God. Thank you because the name of righteous because of Jesus. You can't be good enough to go to heaven. Okay, how good you are. You may not do nothing wrong. You may not steal nothing. You never put your hand in a cookie jar when nobody was looking. You may not have done anything wrong. But for the simple fact that we were born in sin, shaped in iniquity. They don't even recognize the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. But if you don't come to my rescue, I'll be lost. I don't want to be lost. I'm speaking in the place of some sinner today. I don't want to be lost. I'm tired of what I'm doing. I'm tired of the struggle. I'm tired of the ups and downs in my life. I'm tired. I want to trust Jesus. But every time I seem like I'm ready to move forward, something else happened, and it makes us hesitate sometimes. So, well, I'm going to fix this first, and then I'm going to give myself to the Lord, then I'm going to do right. But you know what, brother? That opportunity sometimes don't come the second time. It don't come. And then you are holding the bag. You're holding the bag. Holding the bag. Devil made a promise to you, but then you find out that he was lying. And now you're holding the bag. Oh, you did what I said. You're holding the bag. You left me with a hot bag of promise lies. It's like fool's gold that the devil gives some people. Promise in the world, but when you open it up, find out worms in it and everything. Ain't nothing good to it because the devil don't have nothing good to give you. He ain't got nothing to tell you good. What a bunch of lies. Stop listening to the devil and hear the voice of God. Hear the voice of God. And live, my brother. And live, my sister. You don't have to go to hell. Come on now. God don't want a bunch of Pharisees. We got a lot of Pharisees, religious people today. Praise God. They just talk about how good God is. They everybody got them at the dance. They got the shout. But their heart ain't been changed. Their mind is still defiled. It's still corrupt. Because when they go out of the church, they're doing the same thing that they used to do when they claim they got saved. Hallelujah. We got to change. People, I'm speaking from a human being perspective. I said, we got to change. Humans got to change.
cannot live like this because God's going to judge us one day. He's going to judge us one day. And you don't have to be lost. You hear what I'm telling you, brother and sister? God wants to use you in this church. He wanted to use you to bring somebody to see him. God brought me, healed me with this lung disease. And I went to the doctor a few days ago. I had to rebuke the devil because I also have a claim. I'm trying to get a claim. And I'm trying to get that claim because that's a lot of money. But my lung report was so excellent. He said, your lungs is better than a 60-year-old. You know, as you get older, your lung capacity is supposed to decrease. So I'm at the point where it's supposed to have been decreased. But I'm all above where it's supposed to be. On the good side, on the positive side. I said, man, I said, that's not good for the people. I'm glad to be, thank God for the healing. But I wish you would just delay it a little bit. When it was the worst case of meningitis, or call it cryptococcus. Cryptococcus. Meningitis will kill you. Amen. If you don't get to the doctor in time and all that, amen, it will kill you, man. Take you right out. But have your neck crooked and everything, your mind all messed up. Amen. God delivered me. My mind was getting messed up. I talked to my pastor. Amen. And I found words of comfort in talking to him. Amen. I remember that. Amen. He gave me some words that I can hold on to. And I thank God because meningitis, my mind was so bad it was gone. I was here still trying to preach. And I was up here preaching, getting ready to preach. And here comes the devil. He said, you can't do this no more. These are the words. And I'm looking around like this. I said, you might as well sit down. Then I said, no, I said, you're lying. I can do this. I can do this. So I got up and I struggled through it. That's what we got to do. We got to stand on God's promise. Yes. Stand on the promise. And that's what we got to do sometimes, make a promise stand. If you don't make a promise stand, you may not make it. Sometimes you don't have the support around you. You got to use what God has spoken in his words. Amen. The word of God is real, so that's when you got to make a promise stand. Uh-huh. I got to say it, but the only way I'm going to make it, I got to find the word and stand on the word. Because if you don't have a promise stand, all other ground will be sinking sand. Uh-huh. I said, all other ground will be sinking. Yeah. If you don't use God's word as the support for your life, uh-huh, you're going to go down. But thank God for victory. Thank God for salvation. I'm going through some things, but you know what? The Bible said all things work together for good to them that love the Lord. Amen. That's what I'm doing. I'm holding on to what God said in his word, and I'm making a promise stand. Anybody making a promise stand? Hallelujah. How am I standing? Because I've been promised me something, and I'm standing on it. That's how I get to the end of it. Hallelujah. I'm standing on the promise, like the song said, of Christ my King. Through eternal ages, let the praises ring. Glory to God in the highest. I'm going to shout and sing, for I'm standing on the promises of God. Hosts of hell is assailing against the people of God. But if they hold true to God's word, we're going to come out with a shout. We're going to come out with a glory hallelujah. Hallelujah. What kind of promise are you standing on today? Praise God. You got to stand somewhere. What are you going to say? Somebody say, I'm standing on the rock. I'm standing on the rock. Jesus said, he that hears these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a man that built his house on the rock. So when the floods came, the wind blew and beat upon that house, it fell not. Why? Why? Because it was found on the rock. Hallelujah. Somebody said, rock of ages, clap for me. Let me hide myself in thee. We got a rock today that's sure. The joy is coming in the morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm going to make a promise today. Today, somebody needs to say, I don't know what you're going through, but you said, I'm going to make a promise stand. I was about to give up. I was about to throw in the towel. But now I'm going to stand on the promise. You know what, saints? At the end of every promise, there's a blessing. Come on. There's a blessing at the end of every promise. Hallelujah. But you got to have enough faith like Abraham to wait until the end. One good thing about God's promises is that between the time he promised you and the time when he brings forth the fullness, he's still blessing you as you go. He's still blessing you. You're still getting it. You're still receiving it. Hallelujah. And that's the good thing about being a child of God. God is not a bad payer. Praise God. He's a good payer. Because he wants to encourage you to get there. He wants to encourage you to get there to the fullness. I'm glad that I'm an heir of the promise. We're trying to get to heaven, right? We're trying to get through. This is a journey. And while we're going through it, he's constantly blessing us. Hallelujah. It's only when you backslide and you turn away from God that you miss out on everything. You lose all of the goodies. Everything, you lose it. But you don't have to lose with God because he's a good payer. Hallelujah. He's a good payer. And he's more than enough. Oh, isn't he so good today? He's more than enough. I want you to be encouraged that going through something. I want you to know that God can help you if you stand. He will bless you if you stand. Stand on the promise. Make a promise stand. Crisis is in our lives. Crisis in our homes, crisis on our jobs. But if we make a stand for God, he'll show you that there's something better down the road. I'm crying now, man. I'll be praying here every day. I'm asking God for a breakthrough in areas of my life. I'm believing God. Saints, and you that are seeking God, you got to believe that God don't want you to just have just a little bit. He's the exceeding abundance of all that we think or ask. Amen. He's the exceeding abundance. Don't settle for less. You don't have to settle for less. You don't have to, praise God, take what the devil has given you. God got more than what the enemy got for you. He wants to try to compromise with you to get you to walk out on God. Get you to just live a mundane type of Christian life. Live a half-baked life. And he just keep on teasing you, getting a little bit of stuff in there. But you know what? Don't get out of that company. Get out of that area. He don't care nothing about you. Devil is a liar. Let's get with God now. Let's get with God and stand on his promises. Because there with him is grace and there's promise, there's power. Amen at the end. All right, God bless you. Amen. Let's give the Lord a praise. Amen. In Jesus' name. I am standing
on the promises of God, my Savior.
Let's pray together.